Oh my gosh. All right, so I'm going to welcome you all back to TrendingSA on SABC3. And the reason why, suddenly there are so many dudes in this room.
I've never seen so many before.
You don't even work here.
Who is that?
People from next door.
Anyway, so, okay, thanks, Jovito crew. It's all because of our next guest. Our Tuesday guest tonight is a 23-year-old social media influencer who's gone from a hip-hop dancer to a businesswoman. She describes herself on her Instagram as a CEO, a model, an event host, and she has 800,000 Instagram followers. Teachers, we are your students. But many still wonder who she really is. And tonight, we are hoping to find out a little bit more because this is her very first ever television interview. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Faith and Nketsi to TrendingSA. I couldn't let go. It was weird. I don't know what happened. I apologize.
It's okay, you forgot.
That was intense.
Are you okay, Nins?
I'm sorry. I'm a little bit unable to can. First of all, hello.
Hi.
We danced. Faith. Mm-hmm. Hi.
Hi, good. How are you?
Good. I'm very good. Well, how are you?
I'm good.
Very,
I'm a bit nervous.
Very good.
But I'm
good. We're composed. We're good. thank you very much for joining us. Why is this your first ever television interview? How has that happened?
I don't know, because I'm such a shy person, so I try to stay away from, but now I'm trying to do it. So.
Okay.
It's
beautiful.
Nice.
You are like mind-blowing.
Thank you so much.
People do this all the time. Like when you walk into the bank and they're like, just take the money, it's fine. I wish,
but no.
All right. Tell us a little bit about who Faith Nketsi is.
Okay. Faith Nketsi is a 23-year-old woman. Kimosoto. I grew up in London and I am a businesswoman and a social media influencer.
Nice.
And when you say London, do you mean East London, like Emon?
No. I mean London.
How did you UK? Get to London? Like, what was the story behind
that? Family. Some of my family. My dad. And,
oh, okay. So yeah. Okay.
So you sure it's not a Mond?
No.
Okay. I want to ask the most important question, and I'm sure that everybody that's at home and in the studio and me would like to know. What is your hip-to-waist ratio?
Oh, my goodness. I don't know, hey? Which is so weird.
Is it like 70%?
I don't
hips
know.
And 1% waist. Or like 87% hips. Okay, look. All right, you started off as a dancer.
Yes.
Right. And then you got popular as a dancer and you worked in that space. You developed this a persona, Queen Turk, at the age of 15. And then
16. Yeah.
Okay, at the age of 16. And then you get into sort of dancing. Tell us a little bit about that.
Okay. How I came about twerking is I was on YouTube one time and I saw girls twerking and I was like, okay, I want to try to do that. To my disadvantage, actually, at that time I was going through my family was going through financial problems. So I needed money to pay for school fees. So, you know, emotionally blackmailing my friends, I was like, guys, let's start twerking. And they obviously couldn't say no because they knew my situation. So we started twerking and, you know, we made money and, you know, little did we know that we were going to become famous from it.
More. You became famous from it. Yeah. And then you quit twerking to, the age of 18?
Yeah,
you 18. Quit twerking to become an entrepreneur, businesswoman. Why quit twerking? Why not continue twerking? Why become an entrepreneur?
Well, like I said, I went into twerking knowing exactly what I was doing.
Okay.
So, I wasn't going to twerk forever.
Had accomplished.
Yeah. Mm. So, I wanted to get into beauty salon and that was my dream at that time. So that's exactly what I did. I wanted
so to ask you to twerk now would be inappropriate. Would you twerk? Would you consider?
I'll dance now. I make money. No!
My skirt is
way too tight. I'm so sorry.
But let's talk about business. So feline management and also snatch.
Get snatched.
Get snatched with Faith. Mm-hmm. What do the two do? What is your business?
Okay, Feline Management is a brand development company for social media. So we build female brands through their social media, and you know, we basically show them how to make money. And how me and my business partner and longtime friend Deboho came about it is we went to America and we saw how serious they took social media there, okay, and how, you know, females or anybody that had followers made money out of it. So we came back home, you know, re-strategized, and we were like, okay, this is what we're gonna do, because I had the same followers, but I didn't get money from it. So that's how we came about Feline Management and Get Snatched, which is my passion project. You know, I turned 21, my weight was fluctuating, I was getting bigger, but still doing the same things. So I, you know, I got a diet that worked well. I tried diets, and then I got this specific diet because I took bits and pieces from diets that I was trying before.
Yeah.
And I, you know, compiled a diet that would work for me and my traveling and my life.
Wow.
And that's how I
came about. So if we go on this diet and we use the things in that plastic, we're going to look like you.
No, you will. Yes, you put on the belt. You go to gym. You know the belt.
Can I get a belt? I really want a belt.
I want a belt too.
I've got it right here.
Oh, where is that, girl?
Thank you.
There you go.
So fly.
Thank you. Right. So I want to find out from you. Feline Management. It's not the first time a lot of people are hearing about it. There was a commotion on Twitter with regards to this, and it followed this tweet. So let's look at this tweet by Barry Roo. And it says, Faith Nketsi has been selling young girls. Where is our crime intelligence? Now, this tweet came out a couple of weeks back, and the story then starts getting discussed on Twitter. People are saying what they want to say. I want you to break down the whole thing right now.
Okay, this question gives me so much anxiety. But basically, you know, that was one of the toughest weeks for me ever. You know what I mean? I was, you know, when that tweet came out, I was honestly, first of all, I lost a lot of work. And to just clear it, guys, it is not true. There is no such thing. You know what I mean? And, oh God, it's just, it's crazy. But what this person did and what he said, I do. He, you know, it's deeper than just me trending and it's deeper than me, you know, than him just twiddling with his thumbs at home. It, you know, girls were DMing me, sending me messages saying that they want to be a part of this. What he did, he basically, he made me realize that actually there is a deeper problem here. You know what I mean? Girls can, like, girls were saying, I can do that. Sending me naked pictures of myself saying, I can do that. I don't mind. So we need to now look at the bigger picture of this and find exactly what is wrong in South Africa. You know, is it lack of employment or, you know, yes, that week was traumatizing, but you know, the part that got me the most were the girls, the beautiful girls that were sending me.
So he was just making this up about
you. He glamorized such a dark story.
Yeah.
He literally glamorized
it. It's interesting. So then you've chosen to take from the entire trauma the fact that all of this is happening.
Yeah, no, it actually became, it didn't, it wasn't about me.
Yeah.
So, okay, so you've got an opportunity right here, right now, in front of the whole of the South African public. Is there anything else that you'd like to set the record straight? Can we talk about the Offset situation?
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, we can talk about that.
Yeah. The floor is yours.
Okay. Wow. Whew, guys, I'm such a fan. Like, okay, I landed from Paris. He landed from LA or wherever he was from.
Yeah.
Baggage claim, I saw Offset. I was like, Offset, can I take a picture? As a normal fan. How that escalated to me having a whole affair with him is beyond me. I don't know. So, no.
Wow. So you're not having affairs with Offset?
First of all, Offset is not even my type.
Imagine.
What is your type?
It's
what
an
is
insult.
Your type?
Forget about your type, Lala. Let's talk about a video that leaked of something that was happening on your head. You were busy enjoying yourself. Was it leaked? Was it leaked? Or were you looking for attention?
First of all, if I had to leak a sex tape, let me say this on camera, it would be a sex tape. Okay, so yeah. Yeah, no, it was... I still today, I can't explain how it got out, but... that was also very embarrassing for me, but I got through it. So, yeah, it was with my boyfriend and we were on holiday. It was, I think, our third or fourth year anniversary. And I don't even know how it happened. I was watching TV with him in the hotel room and boom, getting calls and I really don't know how it happened. Still today, I cannot explain to you that story.
Do I look like you yet? Do I look like you?
Follow the diet too.
I have to follow the diet. I've been wearing this for 3 minutes, guys.
I can see your job.
Yeah,
thank you. I want to know quickly as we wrap up, it's Women's Month. What's your positive message for women out there?
Oh, my positive message is can we all just support each other? Mm. You know, I would love to be in a space where women can say, okay, no, I support you. You know, I've got male supporters, I mean, for the obvious reasons.
They're sitting right here on the
stage. Yeah, but I would love for women to actually not hate on other women. And I would love for us to support each other. If that happens, a lot can honestly happen.
Nice.
Thank you. That's Sorry, Casper. Yes, I will be in your video. Yes, I have lost the weight in my waist and put it on. Yes, baby. That's exactly where I put it. That's good. Thank you.
You're amazing. Thank you very much for being here.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you, everybody.
That was easy, right?
Nice.
No, that was left. We're going to take a quick break. This is Trending SA on SABC.
While I'm coming off the court fully drenched, here goes some hater rain, get your thirst quenched. Style doing them in this Burberry trench. These birds copy every word, every inch. But gang, gang, gang.